Hello friends, I am Manoj Mittal. So here I am going to talk about with respect to the Power Virtual Agent and how we can connect the Power Virtual Agent with the Power Automate. So here basically we are going to create a bot using the Power Virtual Agent, and on a runtime what the user is asking their query. So based on that query we are going to hit to the database using the Power Automate. So here we are going to create a table into the Power App. That is the data was. So in that we will store the data, and with the help of the query what user is going to type, we'll just pass this to the Power Automate. Power Automate just take the data from the Power App, filter the queries, and return back the response. So let's see how this entire solutions we can design up, right? So let me come back here. Yep. So this is the screen. Like once we need to log into the Power Virtual Agent. So this is a powerva.microsoft.com. You can log in with your authorized account and you will land on this screen itself. Okay, so this is the section is coming. Here is the all the names, like all the navigation sections. This is the chatbot, the test area, and this is our the canvas area. So, and this is the bot section where we can create a new bot. I'll select the bot and the new bot. I will give the name here M365 event. I'll select a language, English, and click on create. So it will take a couple of seconds and it will do all the hard work for us. In the back end, it will create a bot and give it back to us. So let's wait for a couple of more seconds until our the bot will get ready. All right. Yeah. So in the meantime, so let's create a table. So at least our data will get populated there, and we'll create a schema. So I have an Excel sheet where I have a couple of session details and who is going to deliver that particular session. What is that? It's a track. It's an IT track or the dev track, and it's a breakout session or the workshop session. So let's create a. Let's go to the Power App and create a new table. I logged into the powerapps.microsoft.com. I landed to this screen. I select the data under the table. So just one more thing. Now it has the name has changed. Instead of entities, become the table. And over the so that's why it's just coming up here as table. So I clicked on the new table. I'll just create M365 data. Click on create. So the new table is going to create. So here we have a column. We can create a new column. So name I will take as a session detail, and I will add few more column which will give me the detail. It's like we have the username. As of now, I just take, or like I will take as a speaker, right? I'll just take it as a text. Click on done. And create one more column here. It's a right. I'll click, just let it be text. This one session track and session type. So I click on save table. So my table will get created. So here you can see there are a lot of out of box the columns has appeared, and here we added our custom column. We can create a view and filter based on that, and we can find out what are our custom columns, right? So I will go back here, click on the custom. So it will show what are the custom columns we have and what are the internal names of that particular columns also. So let's sync the data here. So the beauty here is like we can directly just click on edit in Excel, and I can just copy paste the data from the Excel and it will directly come up here. So let's click here, edit data in Excel. So it will download the Excel for us. So let's open that Excel. It's enable editing. So let's load this one. Yep, it's asking for the sign in. So I will take all the session details here. I will put into the column name. I'll take other details. Like we have this users and this session. I'll put against the session speaker name. Oh, this is not okay. And other two columns, what I have, I will take it out from here and put it here. Right, so we got the data. So here I will get the publish option. So as I click it, here the publish. So it will push all the data into the table itself. So let's go and just refresh it. And we'll go back to the data. So you can see all the data has appeared here, right? So if you need to change the view and add some more columns, so click on the view here. So we can select the active view and just click it here. And here we can add other columns what we have. So it will start appearing once we save it and come back there. So I'll save it and publish this view. Let it publish. Yeah, so once I go back, I select the data. So I can see all the data like which has added now. So let's move to the virtual agent. So we can see this is how the new bot has launched. So let's click on the topic. And so topic is the area where we can add the phrases which my bot can understand. And this is the trigger point for the bot. So what are the phrases or like what are sentences we need to edit here? We need to create a topic. So as a bot is having out of the box, the four topics is defined, but we don't need for this demo purpose. I will just off all the topic and we will create our new topic here. And the whatever the sentence I'm going to add here, that will be the trigger point to decide the flow. Right? I click on the new topic and I'll just give the name here. It's M365. So this bot will help to find out speaker and session details. Right. So we'll add a few phrases here. Speaker session interested in interested in sessions, what sessions are covering, right? And what the sessions has covered. Some few words randomly I added. So let's go to the authoring canvas where we can design this section. So once I come back, this is my the canvas area where we can design the entire bot. So you can see once the user is going to type, so this all the sentences and what the topic we have created is the trigger point for us. So after that, so let's see what message we need to showcase to the users. Once user is typed, we'll feel like dear user. Look like you need some information. Need some information. Please select speaker or I can help you. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give the options, two options to the users when they start typing this type of sentences, speaker or the session. So let's add that one, ask a question. So we are going to ask a question from the users. So like choose one option, something. So here is like identify what type of questions we are going to create. We are going to create a multi-choice question. So I will keep the options as a speaker or as a session. So as soon Yes, I am going to do this one, right? It's going to create a conditions for us. So we can scroll it down and check it out. The speaker, we have a one condition, and the sessions, we have another condition. So we'll just change it this variable name, and it's just a where choose option. So check it here. So now we have come back here. So once the user will type the speaker, once or they will select the session, then our request will come to the respective condition. So based on that conditions, we need to perform the actions now. Okay, so let's we'll ask if they ask for the speaker, we'll ask the speaker first name or the last name, so we can query and get the detail. So we'll ask here, ask a question. Can you give me first name or last name? Identify. We'll just take whatever the user is going to type as is that one. We'll just define the variable where speaker name, or like speaker is fine, right? Or similarly, we'll ask here also the question. Can you give the session? So we can give the more detail about the session. So we'll choose what the user is going to give. Same the user entire response. We'll just type it here, where session. So this has done. So we have done till here, right? So let's see how it's work and how we'll reach. And then after that, we'll going to hit to the table which we have created into the Power App or in the Dataverse via Flow, and we'll get back the results and just show the user here. So let's save it. And you see, these are the quite helpful options are there. So here is like the mini map. So once I click it here, I can just move it. Instead of doing the scroll bar here up and down, I can quickly check it out the my entire flow, right? So once I type it here, anything, I just type as a speaker. So see, it's a quite intelligent, that system. Once I type the speaker, so it's understand, I just type as a speaker, dear user, it's look like you need information. So it's immediately came down here and it understand, I just type the speaker. It didn't ask, okay, choose any one of the option. It directly come back here and ask, can you give me the speaker name? Or the speaker first name or the last name. Instead of that, if I ask speaker session, so let's, I think we need to start the restart the pod to start from, because we have left in between. So I'd say the speaker session. Yep. So once I ask the speaker session, so bot is didn't decide. So what condition is going to fulfill? So it asks the questions, right? So we need an option. We need a detail about the speaker, or we wanted information about the session. So I'll select the speaker. So again, it come back to this section, right? So this is pretty intelligent and it can understand what questions I'm going to type based on the trigger, what I have defined already in the system. So let's go back to the flow and create, and then we'll integrate here itself, right? So I log into the flow.microsoft.com here and click to the solution. And for that, we need to create a new solution. And then what are the flow we are going to define here, which can, which will be available within the Power Virtual Agent, and we can connect it accordingly. So let's create a new solution that is M365. I will select our publisher, set the default and versions is fine. I click on create. So it will create the new solution for us, and it's a blank solution. Here we can create a flow. I can select the new, click on the flow. So once I come back here, so there is a actions is available at the Power Virtual Agents. I will select this particular trigger point, when Power Virtual Agent call a flow. So once we are going to call it, we are going to get the variable values which is going to call that particular flow, right? So we'll just define for the speaker first. I will just say as a speaker name. Right, so let it this. I will go back and I will add another values here. So I'll connect with the common data services. So we are going to get the data. I'll select a list record. So here, what are the list we have created? So we have created M365 data. So here, this is the list or this is the table which we have created, and we need to provide the OData query filter here, right? So I will just type it here, contain speaker column name, right? Speaker column name will go back and take it out. What's the column name? Internal values for that. So that we have speaker name we have taken here. Take it this value, come back this one, and this is the variable we need to use, which we have defined above. That's the speaker name. Send to the single quote and the bracket close here. Right, now let's create one variable as a string variable. So I'll just use initialize variable. So here I will type as a speaker. It should be a type of the string. And let's create, and what are the values is going to come. So as we are using the list of records, so one, we can have a multiple speakers with the same name, right? So we need to take the multiple values. So we'll append those values. So we'll create one more, we'll create like append to string variable here. Variable here will say append to string. Yep, so our variable name is speaker, and values we will take it here. Values, it should be, we will take it from here. It can be the list of the values which will come from the list of record. So that will be, I will just take it as a name. So I will give all the sessions name, which will come into the name, and you can see it's a group of values. It's not single. It's automatically convert into the loop itself. So here we can define all these things. It's a session name. It's a name column having this. I will just give it here as a speaker name, right? So we can add that column values also. Speaker, we have. It's a speaker, and we have session track. Track, we'll see what we have for that session track and session type, right? So the last column, what we have, that's a session. So we'll take it this one and just type it here, session. Type, if we have that column, we'll search it out, session type. Yep, we have that column, session type. So once we have done with this, like going to append all the values into the string variable, we'll just use the compose variable and just, and then pass it back to the who is going to call that particular variable, particular flow, right? So I use as a one more as a compose for the data operations point of view, and assign that value which is going to come from the above here, right? That is the speaker as a value, and then add it as a Power Virtual Agent and Power Virtual Agents, and here we need to return the values, and then when we are going to return, it's like a speaker output. So speaker output, here we need to add the value. So what values we are going to add? It's an output which is coming from the compose data operations, right? So that's all. So I think we have done, I will save it, and I'll give the some appropriate name to that one. It's a M365 speaker flow. So let's wait. Let's save it. Yep. So I will keep the name here M365 speaker. So I can identify easily it's a sessions related or the speaker related. So I save it. So let's go back to the Power Virtual Agent. Here I just click on reset. As I ask the questions about the speakers, right? The speaker first name or the last name. So I will just excuse me. Yeah, so this is my speaker section. Here I will invoke the flow, call an action. So here we can create a new flow from here itself, or if we have created into the solutions, we can call it directly here itself, like M365 flow. And here it's like it's expecting the variable. So what we have, it's an where speaker, which will come from the top to here, and it's going to return the value to us, that is the speaker output, right? So here what we can do, we can just post this message. I'll just add the message, show message. So user, here I found the information. Here I find the information and get the detail from this variable itself, speaker output, right? So let's save it and run it how it's work. So right, we have done this corrections, and we'll just come back and just check it out again here, speaker session. So let's check out those results how it's appear. I select the speaker, so I'll provide the name of the speaker. Let's say Manoj. So yep. So we got the detail of the particular speaker. So this speaker is going to demonstrate this particular session, the speaker name, it's what's the track of the particular session, and the workshop type. So let's create for similar way in for the sessions also and complete this bot activity. So I have created a similar M365 sessions, the similar flow within the same solution. So just getting the value as a session detail and getting the value from the list itself, and did the filter and define, just initialize the variable. In that variable, I have just added all the values with respect to sessions, speakers, session detail, session type, and session track, right? And thus using the data operations, assign it to the compose variable and return it back. So let's assign that sections also here. Let's do the reset and go back to this section. I will come back and ask call an action. So here is the session detail. Not this one. I will, yep, appear. I'll select a value. This is a where session coming from here. This is return the value. We'll just type it here, the message. Show message. User, here I will take this variable, it's a session output, and then I have done till here. So let's see if this user just like this, both the things is happening, we'll ask it again. Okay, so like do you need any other information or want to go back again? Yes and no. If you want to go back, yes, and then start the conversation, and no, then end this conversation. So add one more question here, right? So we'll just add it here, ask a question. So let's remove this section. Yep. So we'll ask, do you have any other question? Questions, or do we need any other info? Do you have? Do you want? related to user or session. Fine, otherwise user will ask something which we don't have the phrases in the question and it will fail. So I will give the option select as a multi choice. So options for us it will be yes, and another options will be no. So it will be same for the sessions and as well as for the speaker. So take this particular node, I just click it here and drag and drop. So it will be the common for the both now, right? So here we have a conditions based on yes and no, and we need to proceed for that, right? So if like we have a yes, so let's create a variable for that. Question. That I will just another question. So now we have come back here. So if we don't have any questions, so we can end this one with a survey, right? So this is finished. And now user is having any questions, again we'll say okay, pick one of the options. So we'll take it and put this one on the top again. So if you can see, I'll just add the one message box. And I will select this particular node and I will go to the top and I will pick this node from here. I will connect it, right? So it has connected, pick one option, and this is not required. I'm going to delete this section. So now let's see what we have done till yet. So user is going to ask some of the phrases. We'll come back here. We'll just give the option whether you want a detail from the speaker or want a detail about the sessions. If it's for the speakers, we are going to ask the username, speaker name, first name or the last name. If it's a session, we are going to ask for the session detail, and we are going to call a flow. Flow is taking that detail and going to the Power App tables and get back the result to us. And again, we are asking the question, do you want any other information related to the speaker or the session? If he says yes, then again, we are going back from this conditions to the top conditions here itself, right? If he says no, then we are going to end this conversation with a survey. So let's save and test it out this section. Fit here, speaker session. So if I select here the speaker, I'll just give the name of the user as a first name, so I get the detail of the user. So if I go to the tables and see that data, so against that particular user, what data exists, and this username is Manoj. So here we'll say he is going to deliver the sessions on the Power Virtual Agent, and it's a dev track workshops, and the name is Manoj Mittal. So we'll go back and just check it out. That information demonstrate the business value of the Power Virtual Agent, speaker name, session track, and the workshop, everything is correct here. So let's try for another options what we have. It's asking for do you want any other information or no? So I'll say yes, I want more options. So let's select the session this time. I will just type it here, Power Virtual Agent. So let's see. So you can see, right, it's a pretty much like intelligent and capable system. So I didn't type entire sentence. I just type and it just check it out from there and just come back the information to us, right? So yeah, definitely I use the contain. So that's why it's coming up here, but it still understand all those capabilities there. So it's just giving the information, the session name, speaker name, session type, and session trick. Everything we have, I say, oh, I don't need any other query. So did I answer? Yes, you answer. So I just say give the rating and that's all. So thank you very much for joining me in this video. So if you find it useful, please like, subscribe and comment in the videos. Thank you.